Hello, welcome. Take a moment, read this problem, and then press play and we'll solve it together. Okay, so I actually think I like this problem. I don't say that very often. A lot of the region's problems, it's not that they're badly written or anything, I just don't particularly enjoy solving them. This one I thought was kind of fun to solve. It made me think critically. So it says a sine function increasing through the origin can be used to model light waves. All right, so they're not giving us many specifics here, so the first thing I'm going to do is just sketch an x-axis and a y-axis, and then I'm going to do my best to sketch what I just heard. I heard them say that there's a sine wave that's increasing through the origin, so like this. And I'm just going to keep drawing it. It's going to be cyclic, right? It's going to keep going forever. And violet light has a wavelength of 400 nanometers. That's a way of saying that the period of the sine wave is 400. So here's zero. And the period is typically, we look at the period of a wave by saying, all right, when does it reach one maximum to another maximum? So, like from here to here, that would be a period. But it's also true that you can look at other corresponding points to find the period. So, for example, you could say that one wavelength of this, the period, is right here, right? You can see this is one cycle of the wave. Because if you took this pattern and repeated it, right, this pattern repeated over and over again, you would get the full sine function. So you can choose different points as long as one cycle between those points create and repeated creates that wavelength. So for example, I would not pick just these two points. They're at the same height, but this little chunk right here, if I repeat it, it does not make the sine wave, right? You have to pick points that correspond with equal heights and when put together make the full wavelength. So that tells me that this is at 400. Then what else do I know with the wave? Well, if 0 and 400 are the beginning and endpoints of one cycle of the wave, then exactly here in the middle, it has to be 200. This is the way a sine wave works. And halfway between 0 and 200 has to be 100, the peak of the wave. And then halfway between 200 and 400, 300 is the bottom of the valley of the wave. The sine wave is always has those kind of symmetries where it crosses 0 halfway between essentially the start and end of your wavelength, this case. And then the halfway point between these two zeros is the peak, and the halfway point here between these two zeros is the lowest point, which is beautiful, right? And then we can answer the question because they say over which interval is the height of the wave decreasing only? Well, here I can see that's decreasing, so it's got to be something here, right? So that's between 100 and 300. 0 to 200, you can see it's going up and down, so that's not it. 200 to 400, it goes down then up, so that's not it. And 300 to 400, it's increasing only. So I enjoyed that question. I hope you did too. Thanks.